First, I want to welcome everybody to the second season of the Winterhawks Coaches Show. And our first segment is going to be on seven things that every coach should consider before starting each season. The first one is to decide on a slogan. I believe every year you should have a unique slogan to the group, to the theme, to the goals of the team. And I remember when I was with the Vancouver Canucks, early on, we had a theme for the year of respect. We wanted to get respect back for our team within the city, within the league. And then later, as we developed as a team in year five or six, we had the theme and the slogan of championship habits. We wanted our team to take that next step and go deeper in the playoffs, and we thought championship habits would be a good thing to rally around for the whole year. Number two is to make cuts personal. And what I mean by that is every year we have players trying out for our teams and we have to make selections, and then we have to tell other players that they can't make it. And I think when you're doing that as a coach, no matter how many players are trying out for your team, you should make sure you sit down with that player one-on-one. Or if they're younger, sit down with them and their parents and explain what they need to do to play at that level. But make it personal. Don't just post a list. Don't just send out a notice. The third thing is to develop a priority practice checklist. And what I mean by that is you only have so much ice time and you have a lot of things you want to do. And I find if you try and jam things in right away, you're going to find your team is okay at a lot of things, but not great at anything. And you'll really struggle early to find your identity. The fourth one is to teach skills, principles, and concepts. We want to give the players a framework for the system, but when teaching a system, you should go to the whole part, whole method. Show the whole and then break it down into its parts. And really, the key parts of a system are the skills, concepts, and principles that make up that system. That's what the players need to know. Number five, as we're doing right now, select your leadership group. The correspondence between the coach and the team is really driven through your leadership group, and you're going to rely on them heavily through the year. It doesn't matter what age group, you want to start to develop leaders. So you may have a core group, and then you may have younger players within the team that comes into those meetings every once in a while. And when you're selecting your leadership group, I think it should come from the coaches, but with input from the team. So how do you get input from the team? Simply ask them. Get them to fill out a questionnaire. Which players would they want to go for dinner with? Which players would they want as a roommate on the road? Which players do they look up to? And that'll start to give you a framework of who they identify as the key leaders within your team. Number six is to outline a team building plan. What you should do, much like your practice plans, is outline a team building plan for the year. You should have at least one activity a month. And sometimes we all get enamored with team building and we think it has to be these fun, engaging activities. Well, it does. I think it's good to do it outside the arena. It's good to do it when you're on a road trip. But the key part of team building for me is players getting to know each other and as coaches getting to know the players. The better you know each other, the closer you'll be and the tighter bond you'll have as a group. And the final point, number seven, is to manage parents and expectations. I know when my son and daughter were playing sports, some of the most effective teams I felt had a manager that was a buffer between the parents and the coach. And they could bring information both ways and they had really good personal skills. And as far as managing expectations, I think it's important early in the year to meet with the team and meet with the parents at the same time. Outline practices, games, training. What is your identity as a team? Make sure everybody has a clear understanding of where you're going as a group. And having said that, I want to wish all of you good luck with the start of your season.